to address Indian problem. That is where my quest started with at Nimble Vision. Today's agenda is like this. So just I want to go through my experience. Last 20 years I've been associated with well-known government and private companies. What I learned, what is the need of the hour, the current generation, what they need, and the role of academia, the government. This is the agenda. Introduction, basically I will run through what has been changed in last 20 years. That is how my journey is all about, the technology, the electronics, software part, how it has evolved. Secondly, employee or employer. See, when I passed out in 2001, remember the twin tower collapsed. So it was a very long time to get into job market, look for a job. We literally struggled, majority of struggled. But today if you see, really we need to look for a job. I think that scenario is completely changed. We need not have to look for a job anymore. The infrastructure or the environment is so robust that we can be employer. So that I will conduct that agenda. And the current, what is the support system available in India and outside? And how the government, state level or the central level, what are the schemes are available, the technology support, funding, maybe the brief overview of that. And how it is difficult to build a technology chain. Way back in 2020 or 2002 or early 90s, how that journey, just I will give an overview on that. And what is the collaboration between academia and startups can help, both of them. One for startups as well as academia also, how the mutual collaboration can help to bring more innovations or more entrepreneurs, that I will cover. And finally, what Nimble Vision, as we are a team of 20 people, 50% we all come from Kalburgi, say we EIC to the one batch. So this is my brief. This is the evolution of electronics and IoT and software from 1990s to up to here. If you see what has been changed. If you see in early 90s, everything was a standalone systems. You hardly had conventional sensors which were wired, and data either we used to store some LCD display or a 7-segment display. That was the technology, it was there. That's all. Whether you take any industrial automation, people have to go to that particular site and see the data and understand, take the decisions. The technology has evolved right from 1990s to today, 2023, where we are. The complete, the domain shift has happened. The IoT, the technology, the communication protocols, 4G, 5G, now we are also talking about 6G. This has completely changed way we get the data or visualize the data or take the action, and how the dependency of the all the manual way of doing is completely changed. So that is about this, all the journey of this. I think the Indian contribution is not so great so far has been, but fortunately last 5 to 10 years what I can see, the huge change, the way the hardware promotion or make in India promotion is happening. Without hardware, I think going ahead, none of the technology will exist. Mere software development is no more going to be a niche area. I think last 20 years was a golden window for all of us to celebrate being a software exporters. I think go ahead, software will be completely free. That's what I'm going to tell it. If you think that software, developing a software, I will make my career, I think we are on the wrong path. Hardware comes, software development is only either you need to be an entrepreneur or an employee. Then only you can survive and sustain. Otherwise, jobs are no more secure for anybody. So that's a fact. So what really changed this whole thing is the technology or the evolution only because of this communication protocol. If you see how this Jio came and made this data packet less than 100 MB, 2 MB for 50 rupees, that completely changed how the technology everyone has started occurred. Otherwise, if you remember early 2000, we used to pay for both incoming and outgoing calls. We were scared to make incoming calls or receive because they were charging both. So because of this communication, the data is more easily accessible, the whole, not only the domestic or industrial applications though, you can be easily used. That is the reason the communication has changed. And there are different communication protocols based on the need. For example, you are in urban India, where you are in a rural India, or the dense population, based on this various communication protocols, like Bluetooth is inside house. Then you have a Wi-Fi again inside house, then the LoRa, 4G, 5G. These are all based on the need, the communication distance. We need to choose all these things. So that one, if you see our stall is outside, in that way, we are showcasing our Wi-Fi, 4G and 5G based solutions, how we have customized. So we have been associated with Qualcomm of India, and we are the winners of Corpo Media Design Challenge 2022. We showcase how 5G and vision can change the conventional way of industrial automation. Instead of sensors, we can do the vision camera-based, AR-based, ML, then take all the decisions. Vision in the conventional sensor way, the problem is that you have to do recalibration or all that what is required. Because the vision brings all those things very easy. You don't have to do anything such things. So this is the one, various how what 5G brings. Speed, signal, big data, internet, network, technology, internet of things and traffic. See, India has made a huge contribution so far in the 5G technology because of various schemes, if you see the central government has introduced. DOT as one of the pioneering, helping so many startups to bring indigenous 5G technologies, your own hardware technology. Their massive grants have given. We are also one of the recipients, and some startups have received up to 10 years grant. Just to make in India, these are the technologies which have been made for exporting as well. Not only for our consumption, they are also helping startups to even export as well. So that is all the options are available for us. So next comes is, I hope you are our seniors, you have been to employers, employees. But today's generation, I think anybody can be visually the condition that if your ancestors or forefathers bit rich, then easier to go on a business model. See, particularly like me, my father was a high school headmaster. For us, being a visionary, thinking as a can I become a businessman? That was a distant thing. By childhood, I was already told, get a job, get a job, get a job. See, we are fed always that you have to get a good job, good salary, and that's all is your achievement. But I think as a parent now, when I see my kids, I don't want to see that. I don't want my kids to struggle, look for a job which will never satisfy our own needs. I think now the things have changed. You always look for your kids to become entrepreneurs. So the employee has, being an employee, there is one way. You can do a regular job, fight a lot of classes, you have to meet somebody's expectation, all this. Being an entrepreneur, this brings a huge of freedom. What you want to do? Your own passion, your own technology solutions, implement it, showcase it, and get recognized and help the society as well. So that is where I believe, because I have played the role of both. I have been an employee for 16 years and now I am an entrepreneur for the last 5 years. I can see what is the best thing for us. It is not only the self-satisfaction, but also I am trying to help the society with my own innovations. So that what you call the satisfaction is more. This is what we have to, as academy also have to bring in our curriculum, saying that just don't look for placements and salary and hiring, which never going to wait. And we are not sure how long this job will be remaining. If you are an entrepreneur, you can define your own career and you can also give jobs to others. So that is the best part. If you are able to give jobs to your own classmates, then what? That is the biggest satisfaction for lifelong you are giving. So that's what I believe. India, we are in this path where we have to promote entrepreneurship. Just looking for a salary or employee, those days are gone. And this is the only way we can sustain and everybody will become a self-satisfied or a financially well as well. And we don't have to go backward anymore. See, there are so much options available in Tier 2 cities. Unfortunately, Kalburgi, we are left behind. That's the reason we are here. I am setting up my office here. So if you take other regions, whether it is Hubli, Belagavi, Dharwad, Mysore, these have made a significant more progress where we are a little bit lagging behind, and here is the opportunity for us to scale actually and bring the technology on the companies here and give a job. And we can be an expert on technology right from here itself. That's what my thought process. So what are the support systems available for startups in India as of now? There's a huge ecosystem in India actually as of now. I think we are in top 10 as a startup ecosystem. So many startups now. The central government has come up with a startup India and Karnataka as a startup Karnataka. There are a lot of facilities and support system is there. See what happened to the 19, I left my job and I got into full time. I was thinking, okay, I have money for 1 year. But suddenly COVID happened. So what? We are completely confined to home and me and my wife, both are founders are full time. What we should do? And thankfully Karnataka Elevate happened, 25 lakhs grant came. So that was the savior for us. So after that, one after one, lot of grants we have received, the work private, central government, many people, that has helped us to scale where we are currently. Currently we have customers in India, Indonesia, and now we are also starting our operations in USA as well. And lot of patents. In India, the awareness about patent is very negligible. We always do jugaad many times and we never look for a professional solution.
That is where the problem actually, or what process has to change. If you take the US companies, what they do, they don't just do the inventions, they patent it. Today if you take Apple, Samsung, Qualcomm, what are they much like? Qualcomm alone makes $300 million every year just by licensing the patent. Nothing to do. Do innovation, patent them, make money by licensing them. This is what the academy of people have to educate the students. Just don't do innovation. Let it go and somebody patents, take all the royalty. This has to be done. The good invention, professional way has to be done, and also patent them. That's very important. And for patent to file, there's a lot of incentives from Karnataka government, central government, both of them. And even private companies also do funding for that one. Lot of events, competitions, grants, and tax exemptions. There's a tax holiday for all the startups for 3 years. This is very good. You don't have to pay for 3 years. You can claim it. Within 5 years window, you don't have to pay any tax. You can claim that one. So there's a lot of benefits in India to start a company and do what you want to do and help the society as well. So coming to this, how easy or difficult to do a big technology jet? Today, if you see in India, in worldwide, how many Indian companies have come with one well-known solution which is part of every household? Any answers? See, unfortunately, we Indians have not done any inventions which is part of every household in worldwide. We are only focusing on software as a service. We are only doing that kind from last 20 years. Because I believe 20 years back there was nothing. Doing the SaaS only development was the only option for laptop. But today, if you see this 2023, the top 100 innovation companies, only one company is here. Rest all either American, European or Chinese companies are there. Only Tata is the name here. Why it is so? Because we never focus on real inventions. Only software, we always try to make money. That's all is so far our achievement. I think today we have to go and particularly at academy level, tell students that what these other companies are able to do it. So take your automotive domain itself. See, we have a Tata, this Volkswagen, Mercedes. These are all more than 100 to 150 years are there. And who is the richest person now? Any idea? Musk is the richest person now. See, this guy came from nowhere. In last 10 years, Tesla is the number one automotive domain company. Rest all, you name it, GM, Chevrolet, all, no, there's no such thing. See, that is the potential the invention has. If you have a good thought process, you have a good product thinking, then come, then support is there. Then you know not just the money, you have recognition, everything is on the table. That's what I want to tell. We need more inventions which are drastically out of the box. Not the conventional just software, app, web, see, these are all gone then. I don't believe if somebody says I'm a good developer, good app, that criteria is no more considered as a good criteria. Can you bring an end product? That is what the need is there. We don't need a developer or we don't need a tester. We need an integrator who can see some open source. And nowadays, entire software stack is open source. If you take GitHub, GitHub has all the software solutions what we need. Even if you take every company, whether it is Cisco, Bosch, all these companies, they use 90% of this software as open source. Nobody is developing from scratch. If you really use it, I remember I used to do assembly coding when I first joined. 80851, I used to do it. Those days are gone. Even Bosch didn't give internet connection to their employees. They thought that then somebody will go wrong and everything. That was the day. But now, every company, the oldest, very conservative companies like Bosch also, they use open source in their software stack. And that is the reason I say that anybody can be an entrepreneur now. Need not to be only the well-funded or well-financially stable, very techie, all that. Need not required. Go to make GitHub, you are at the second house. Download, customize, try it, deploy it, scale it. That's all is required. Only the hardware part is a bit difficult, and that is where the support system is required. That's where we can help. We have a good connect with the hardware integration, and we can help any hardware customization as well. So coming to the academia and startups and innovation. This is a very good marriage between the academia, startups and the business. See, currently in India, this collaboration is very good. What I think in IITs, this is very good. The alumni, they do lot of collaboration, they do lot of funding back to their colleges. But this is not the same case with the Tier 2 engineering colleges. I miss that connection here. See, we are meeting with the first time, I think last 20 years I am here. But maybe we should make this more frequent. and giving back to the college needed. Whether the one is the technology, one is the money, all that is very good. Because a lot of funding comes as a joint collaboration. Since the TDB, the Technology Development Board, is there, they give a lot of grants, up to 10 year grant if the academia and the startup come as a collaboration as a team. Because they feel that this is a startup alone may not do everything as expected. There is the academic knowledge and there is the startup ideas there. If this collaboration comes in picture, then more innovations can come. Particularly what I believe is that going ahead, agriculture is going to be a more and more focused area where huge investment is going to come. After that, it's the climate tech and sustainability. These are the focus areas going ahead where the massive billions of dollars are going to be coming up. So academia, particularly I see the year last Karnataka, our whole this Surdal, Jawar, all this, millet. These are very good, where you can bring the next generation technology, either you can increase the yield, efficiency, all that, very good innovations can become, the huge funding can happen. So these are the some various domains or the areas where the innovations can happen. One is the logistics, smart parking, water management, healthcare, wearables, transportation, sustainability, smart cities, smart retail, and agriculture as well. So these are the various, which appeals to you, you have to pursue it. Need not to be that, okay, this guy is doing, I need to copy all that. I think that we need to come on. If you see in India, the craze was edutech, few days back. Some edutech companies succeeded, okay, let's go ahead, I will also make one edutech company. Some fintech company came, I will also do one fintech company. I think that herd mentality we have to leave. Bring your own innovative solutions, ideas, which nobody has done it. And that is the need of the hour. Then only we'll scale and we'll grow, not only financial, valuation, sustainability, everything will come into play. So this is my team. My wife is Shri. We are the co-founders first. And I have also Deepak Suryavanshi. He is also my co-founder. Same class. Mallikarjun Murali. He is also my classmate. He is also. And Shweta is my junior, again from PDA. She is my US co-founder. She is heading my team in US. So this is where actually I want to tell my experience, how I started. I live in Sarjapur, Bangalore. We are dependent on tanker water supply. So just we are overusing water. We are paying almost like a 10 tankers per month. I was asking my wife, why you are using so much water? Then she put a question back to me. I don't know who is using it. You tell you are an engineer and find a solution which can help me to understand my consumption. So that is how the genesis of Simplevision started. Now we have a solution which without water meter reduce water consumption. See, when I pitch this idea to IITs, they locked on my page. Boss, we are using from last 50 years water meters. You say without water meter, how you can measure consumption? So this is the mentally we are blocked. We don't think out of the box. Now just it is an improvised water level controller and it does water metering also. With hourly water usage, even leakages also we detect. It is a basically a small AI, which is a pattern recognition. So currently we have customers both B2B, B2C and B2C as well. It is a scalable solution for all the segments as well. And it's a quality part, how we visualize the any water quality required, whether the drinking water or MCP or the lake, pond, everything we can do. And it also brings automation, particularly like a big apartment like Brigade. These are our customers in Bangalore, where we are helping, there are 24 buildings are there. They have to go and pump on, all this year, which completely eliminated. These are all completely automated, a small system takes care. Even the borewell, even borewell works only for 30 minutes, let's say. And it needs another 1 hour break, again in the water to rejuvenate. We have AI system that takes care of that as well. You don't have to go, turn off, it's going in dry run mode, all that is completely taken by our software. So this is a technology, we have a sensors in water tank, underground tank, it is connected to the cloud and the data comes to our web and app dashboard. So this is what you have done, when I joined Qualcomm India Design College, they told me you have a choice, you can choose either 4G and 5G to improve your solution. Because there are many people who are choosing 4G, I thought, okay, anyway 5G is the new, let's see what I can do with 5G. That's how our quest with 5G started. What we showcase is vision-based automation. So that helps us to get the award and a very good prize money as well. And many the big apartments and industries have a very complex plumbing system. The motor walls and everything. That is the reason we brought VR here. In VR what you do, you can virtually can interact whole facility. You can do opening, closing, motor on, motor, all that can be done using VR itself. So I am very fortunate from last year being supported, and because of all this tech and impact, I got an opportunity to talk to our Prime Minister last year in India Mobile Congress, where they told me 30 seconds, you have only 30 seconds. But fortunately, Modi ji, he only extended the discussion to 3 minutes, and he not only appreciated what we have done, I clearly told him, Modi ji, आप जल जीवन मिशन में तो पानी हर घर को दे रहे हैं, लेकिन ये पानी कैसे कंज्यूम हो रही है अभी किसी को पता नहीं. So that is what I am doing here. So he was so smart, within 30 seconds here, आप पानी के हिसाब से कर रहे हैं ना. If you see that video is also on YouTube channel available, you, maybe you can have a look. And also I met Roshan, lot of NASCO people, all that, and even Raju Chandrasekhar and Telecom Minister, Junior Minister, last this. And we have got more than 30 hours so far from various, you know, government, private institutions and everything, like Bangalore Chamber of Commerce, NITI Aayog, NSS, NHP, ICT, and Smart City Awards, Science Awards, Qualcomm. Qualcomm were the design winners for 2021. So most recent to this American Society for Mechanical Engineering, this award all the way from US they came to give us. So that's the biggest satisfaction. It's like a C.V. Raman Award in US, and we are the recipient of that. And next one is the UN Water Change Maker Award. This is a globally top 30, the water companies, we are one of them. So this is done by UN itself. So coming to this, what is my vision? See, I am Pakka Kannadiga, Pakka Kalburgi Munsha. So just I want to make Kalyan Karnataka as California of India. See, I went to California the other day. The challenge is same. See, you say, Nankadi Patti Bhumi and Theatre, exactly Hungary and Ardu actually. Same current everything. Only the technology has made them so rich that now it drives everything. So we are also saying, we are also engineers, very qualified people. What we need to bring that, can we emulate that model, make Kalyan Karnataka as calibrator? That is my vision. So today I am here, I am requesting all of you to not only, I am part of Kalburgi here from your Kathapika office. You can help us how, I am also part of 3D engineering. I am already helping some interns as a giving my own project. And training them as well. That's what we are already doing. We want to save this, and we also want to do this 4G and 5G IoT model manufacturing here over the period of time. Since we are already partnered to Qualcomm, they are willing to help us. We can set up this manufacturing plant here itself. All we need is some more space, some more scaling is required. Then that $1 billion industry you can set up in Kalburgi itself. That is what our vision. One is the manufacturing and exporting, second part is the fishery irrigation. These two can make Kalyan Karnataka definitely California of India in 10 years. Thank you. That's all.